Now let's move to the graphical method. The graphical method. The graphical method also is something easy. Yeah, you can see that the Kremser equation is easy too. So the graphical method is just that we are going to draw a graph of x-axis. You know how to draw a graph and y-axis, right? X-axis and y-axis. And from what we have in our separation column, we will have xA, we will have yA, you know them, mass fraction of the extremes, we will have xB, we will have yB. Yeah, you can remember them from the diagram. I don't have to go back to the diagram. So if we are to draw a line in a graph, you know that we need certain points. So now we will have this xA and yA, the points, as numbers, but they will not be enough for us to draw a graph. We know that 2 points are not enough for drawing a graph. We don't know that the graph, will it be a straight line? If it's 2 points, you have, will it be a straight line? Will it be curve or something like that? We don't know. So we will need a certain point. So since xA and yA are for our top stream, xB and yB for our bottom stream, so within the lines of the column, we will need a plate N. Let's call a certain plate, plate N. You can see it. Let me go back to the diagram. Can you see this place? Plate N. So let's call that certain plate, plate N. And we are going to account for X and Y at that certain place. X and Y at that certain place. Let's say XN and YN. XN and YN. Since XN is coming like this, we will have ln xn, and here we will have what? Vn yn. So we are going to find the certain number of the mass fractions at that place. We're going to call it what? Xn and yn. If we have this xn and yn, we have a minimum of 3 points. So since we have a minimum of 3 points, we can draw our line. This line of xA, yA, xN, yN, and xB, yB is called the operating line. Since we are going to be given another equation called equilibrium line, y is equal to mxE, that or mx asterisk, xE and x asterisk all mean x at equilibrium. So from this, we are going to determine some values of y and x. And if we determine those values, we are going to draw the equilibrium line. From that equilibrium line, we are going to be drawing triangles at the edge of the two lines. The operating line and the equilibrium line. We are drawing these lines vertical and horizontal. As it touches the other, then go back to vertical. As it touches the other, go back to the horizontal. So if we draw this, you can see that we are going to have some triangles. Call this number one, number two, number three. So the number of our triangles is the number of places we have. Number of triangles is the number of plates. I think from this I have explained everything about the concept of absorption and stripping and the two ways we can solve absorption and stripping. Then is the number of ideal plates. Number of ideal plates. We can have the number of real plates, or you can be given the number of real plates and you'll be asked to find the number of ideal plates. How can we do it? No, it's directly from efficiency. Efficiency is going to be number of what? Number of ideal plates all over number of real plates. So in case you'll be given efficiency to determine the number of real plates. So after finding your number of ideal plates, you just divide them by the number of real plates to find the efficiency or the other case. I hope you all understand everything I've just tutor you under absorption and stripping, and you can all solve them now using Kremser equation and graphical method. Let's meet in the next video for solving of some examples of absorption and stripping using Kremser equation and using the graphical method. Thank you all.